I just completed installing foam board on the walls in my basement. The process was new to me, but I learned a few things along the way, which may prove useful to some of my viewers. So I installed Foamular 150 by Owens Corning. This particular foam board is 1.5 inches thick for an added R value of 7.5. I cut it to size and then glued it to the walls using foam board adhesive. For some of the gaps that existed between the panels, where it was narrow, I used some more of the adhesive, and where the gaps were a little bit larger, I used some Loctite expanding foam. Finally, I went over all the seams with the seam tape that's also provided by Owens Corning. First, I need to measure the height of my wall. The foam board came in bundles of 8. I purchased 2 bundles to start, and they came wrapped in plastic. I just need to transfer my measurements to the sheet and cut. I use a straight edge made out of a flat piece of aluminum and score with a sharp utility knife blade. I make a couple of passes with a straight edge. Follow up again without the straight edge, making a deeper cut. Then simply snap and break. I flip the sheet over to apply adhesive to the backside. In this particular case, the sheet is symmetric, so it's not necessarily warranted, but it will be for sheets that I need to trim to odd sizes. I applied adhesive in little piles as opposed to using a technique where you can just put waves of adhesive on the backside in an attempt to minimize the amount of adhesive I actually had to use. I glue up my first sheet. Once I have it in place, the adhesive holds it up nicely. I need to accommodate my water main, the shutoff valve, and the drain. So here I'm marking off where I need to trim it back. I make a notch for where the water main penetrates the wall, and then carve out a vertical section so I can slide it behind the water main. And I also cut out a notch around the east window. Since this is the very first sheet to be installed on this wall, I check for plumb. I carve out a pocket to accommodate the drain valve on the next sheet, but then realize that I need to remove more material to actually clear the handle itself. So here I just use a serrated knife, which is actually sold for this purpose, and then test fit the sheet before moving on. I marked the vertical dimension on the foam board to accommodate the west window and check for plumb again. Then I slip a tape measure behind the foam board to measure the horizontal dimension back to the right-hand side of the west window, and simply write that dimension directly on the foam board. And then I repeat for the upper dimension as well. And I glue up that sheet. I'm going to use this Loctite tight foam to fill in some of the larger gaps that I've created, just because my walls weren't even. And when I did the trimming, I didn't get things exact. So it comes with this little applicator. And screw on the thing. I didn't know what to expect when I first got started applying gap filler. So I'm just going to take my saw and just go ahead and trim it. It's time to tape the seams. The flat seams are pretty straightforward. You just need to peel the backing paper back and keep it out of the way as you slowly press the actual seam tape against the joint. And just work your way down the wall. Once you get near the bottom, just kind of need to fold it back on itself, take a sharp utility knife, and trim. I'm going to do this corner. So this stuff is really sticky, and it's kind of stretchy. So you would be really hard pressed to peel the backing in there and try to get that tape in like so. So notice the backing is actually split. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to peel off one side of the backing like so. You don't want to fold it in on itself because you'll never get it unstuck. Okay, so I'm going to go about a foot or so. Now what I'm going to attempt to do is I'm going to attempt to fold it over on itself lengthwise. Get it stuck up here. I'm going to go over a little bit. Got to pay attention to the backing. Okay. Then I'm going to try to fold it over like so. Okay, and you see where I have the backing peeled back here? So I'm probably down about 16 or 18 inches. Then I'm going to stick the corner of the fold inside the corner. Okay. And then I want to get it as tight in there as I can. I didn't do a perfect job up top here. Okay. So now what I can do is, now that I got a start, okay, I can peel this backing back a little bit further. Fold it in on itself some more. Okay, come down here and try to get it in the corner. Okay, like so. The first side all done and pressed in pretty well. What I need to do is fold this back. The outer edge, especially if it's folded in half exactly, the outer edges are sticking together. I'm just gonna kind of unstick it a bit. Okay, so now it's unstuck. Now what I'm going to do is make sure that I got that crease, the corner, packed into the corner real good, just like so. Now what I can do is I can just score the very top here, so I can fold that back. Peel off my backing. I'm going to peel it back on itself, like so. Okay. And then just kind of slowly working down, okay, especially pressing into the joint, okay, just start working your way down. I'm just using my tips of my fingers to press it into the corner, just pulling the backing out at a bit of an angle, and so on. So I've completed installing the foam board in my basement and thought I would just pan around to show what it all looks like. Now I decided to use foam board to create a more or less continuous barrier around the perimeter of the part of the basement that I've actually finished, with the exception of the windows, of course. Now you'll notice that I also have my treated lumber base plates bolted to the floor, because I'll be installing a floating wall to accommodate the expansive soils that we have here in Colorado. I'll also be adding regular bat insulation to the framing once it's all installed, so I'll have a nice, pretty high R value and have a reasonably warm space to work in. If you find this video useful, please give me a thumbs up below and consider subscribing to my channel to follow along with me on my basement project.